Whoa, and welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick. I guess the game knows we want to go back this way. Do we really? We're definitely not Heritage Hill yet. Back to First Fires is the only way? I thought we came here from... I don't even know. I thought I came here from Blackberry, if I remember the name right. So we're gonna get some rest, and we're gonna head to the Crucible Keep to deliver Vianna's research to... They're at First Fires, but we can't rest in First Fires. To Clyver, Commander Clyver, and we do have to drop a shipment off or something like that to the guy in the Fox and Goose. So we might as well go to the Fox and Goose and do our quest there and rest. Seems like a no-brainer to me. We have to go to a whole bunch of places, huh? I wonder if we should stop by... We have to go somewhere else in Copperlane. I wonder if we should stop by there on the way. I'm trying to remember where exactly. It's either the Scrivener's Dormitory or that, Hall of Revealed Mysteries. I'll check that out in a minute. I wish it would stop doing this. Like, where are we over here? Just a guy? No, it's Bishop. Gareth, that's who we need to talk to for deliver a package to Gareth. Okay. Hail, sir. A man skulks near the bar. He seems like he's trying to blend in with the wood paneling, and he watches the other patrons out of the corner of his eye. He gives you a quick nod as you approach. What do you do here? Have I ever talked to this guy? Me? I'm just minding my own business. Perception 11. Of course, you're just standing by yourself in the corner of a room and you're not drinking anything. Not suspicious at all. Gareth's nervous eyes dart around the room. Keep it down, will you? I really am here to do business, but it's the kind of thing that requires discretion. And unless a mutual friend has sent you to me, that's all I've got to say on the subject. He has, actually. Rooters. He peels his gaze away from the bar. Yeah? Verzano has a delivery for you. He glances around and snatches the pouch from you. Keep your voice down, will you? The Dominoes have spies everywhere. He tucks the pouch away. You tell Verzano this is the last time I'm buying from him. It's getting too dangerous for me. What do the Dominoes have to do with this? You have no idea, do you? Let's just say that Dominoes have exclusive rights to trade certain merchandise within the city. Verzano likes to make some extra coin from time to time by dealing in the same merchandise, undercutting the competition, he says. Did I just do something illegal? No, he grins weakly. I'm gonna lie and say I don't think I've heard of the Dominoes. The more important thing is making sure they don't hear of you. Their old Brackenberry stock... Black... Brackenberry, not Blackberry. I said Blackberry before. But these days the Dominoes are known for their business activities, most of which involve some degree of bribery, extortion, theft, or murder. All the things that this fine land was founded on. Tell me what was in that pouch. Bitter squash seeds. They interrupt pregnancies. Even though they're not exactly legal, many folks nowadays prefer them to the risk of hollowborn or a celibacy. He pulls a wry frown. Is it an abortion pill? Or is it like a day after pill? Because that makes a big difference with me. I mean, everyone does what they want to do. You know, I'm not going to put politics into this, but there is a difference. I'm curious as to which it is. Are we done? Yeah, we're done. Now get out of here before we didn't rest yet. Someone named Dana. A woman swaggers in, her polished boots thwacking the floor with slow, deliberate steps. A crooked sneer warps her smooth face. Gareth, I'm hurt. You promised to buy only from me. What's a girl to think? Gareth bows, his knees knocking together. Please, my lady, I was just explaining that I don't do business with anyone else. This is going to be a battle. Who are all these people? Except this one last time, right? Dana crosses her arms and rocks back on her heels. There's always one more deal. Until you run out of credit, there it is. Dana turns and regards you, looking up and down. And just who are you? You don't exactly look like a seed dealer. Aloth glances at Gareth. I think that's a compliment. This isn't all us. Like, who's that? Who are these people? No one to be trifled with. Her grin widens. I just might have a use for someone like you. Versano put you up to this, didn't he? That old fool's on a sinking ship, and he's determined to drag anyone who gets close enough down with him. She eyes the trembling Gareth. Gareth here knew better, but I'll give you the benefit of a doubt. In fact, I'll also give you a chance to get even with the imbecile who's been playing us both. She narrows her eyes. What do you say to killing Versano? Why would I want to do that? Why wouldn't you? He's used you to do his dirty work, and without telling you anything about what you were carrying or who you were crossing. Actually, he did tell us what they were. She taps a finger to her jaw, and her voice slows. Of course, I'd also consider it a personal favor, and House Dominel is never stingy with its friends. She glances at Gareth. The loyal ones, anyway. What if I kill you instead? Is there another option? But okay. Tell me about the Dominels. I don't know whether to be relieved or insulted. We're one of the wealthiest merchant families in Defiance Bay. Let's just say, however, that some of our business practices are not officially sanctioned. Gareth groans and stifles a sob. I'll decide his fate when I talk to him again. You'd better make up your mind quickly, because we're going to pay him his dues one way or another. Just make sure you stay out of our way. I don't see a reason to kill him. Those people are gone, okay. And Garrett's gone. Have I read this one? I believe I have, yeah. Alright, so let's rest.
Hello.
Vixen's Burrow. I like Vixen's Burrow. Seem to be used some useful attributes to get a bonus in. So let's get out of here and head to, what do you call it? We're heading to the Crucible Keep. What was he saying?
A weak academic! You don't usually grace me with your flattery, priest. What merits this attention?
All Rawatai's history is war, same as everyone.
If only the world were led by soft-hearted giants who waste their muscles stroking their own quills. Oh, wouldn't that be grand?
I'm content to remain a burr in your boots. But here, if you but stand on the docks, you can single-handedly ensure no one ever sails to the Deerwood again.
All right, guys, keep it down over there. Now, these guys are not at all aware that we killed Penhill. Eorn. I don't remember who that is in the scheme of things. I'm looking for information on Eorn. He crosses his arms and spits. Filthy little flea picker. What did you want to know? Do you know where he is? Rumors say he fled to the catacombs after he murdered the knight. As much as I'd love to string him up, I don't have anyone I can spare to go crawling in that filth to check for him. How did he manage to kill a knight of the Crucible? Now there's a question. Witnesses say he was drunk and arguing with the man. If I had to guess, I'd say the sneaky bastard had a weapon on him and took the Justiciar by surprise. The coward ran off before anyone knew what he'd done. That's all I wanted to know. Looking for the rest of an Orland man named Eorn. Oh! That's the edicts I keep finding. Okay, I don't know actually where it is. Quest? Quest info? Yeah, Edict of Arrest. Okay, yeah, we haven't found him yet. Clyver told us about him, and that's about it. Because these people are none the wiser. Do they even know he's gone? I mean, they should. He was killed right in frickin' Brackenbury. Hail! Dunstan. Commander Clyver said you're working with an animancer to build forge knights.
So much for his talk of secrecy. I'm building Cleaver's metal warriors. He says they're what we need to keep order in Defiance Bay, so...
He shrugs and shakes his head. Do you disagree with Clyver about the forge knights? I disagree him on near about everything, and this is no exception. These forge knights won't solve our manpower problem. He can call them what he wants, but they aren't knights. Sagani says, doesn't take Itumak's nose to smell the trouble here. A group that can't stand together is headed for a fall. Dunstan folds his arms and looks at the ground. And don't get me started on the other problem. Those souls he's bought to power the forge knights? Clyver keeps telling himself that they come from willing donors, but he knows better. There's a reason you have to buy souls through less than legal channels. We should be clearing those scavengers off the road and not doing business with them. How are you creating these forge knights? Suits of armor and souls. Cleaver's had me repairing and reinforcing used armor for months now, just so we can fill them with some poor sod's essence. He wipes his shining brow. As long as that scholar girl's got her numbers right, infusing the armor with a soul won't be that hard. But that's not what bothers me. Speaking of the scholar girl, you need Vianna's research to complete them. She's been working out a method to transfer the souls into the armor. Getting the process just right is critical. He holds up one hand. Bind the souls too tightly and you get something like those flesh constructs at the sanitarium, barely bright enough to avoid walking into a wall. He raises his other hand. But bind them too loosely, and they'll be too self-aware for their own good. Mad killers in metal bodies. Enough about the Forge Knights, if only. I give him the research. I think this is what you've been looking for.
That's what Cleaver's been looking for anyway. If you found it, I guess I've got to start.
You don't sound too happy about this. I'm not, and I've made it clear to Cleaver that this is a mistake. Trying to harness souls like this, it's a crime against the gods, and it's bound to earn us more trouble than it seems. But Cleaver's given me his orders, so I've got to build these things as best I can. Anyway, Cleaver's told me I'm to sell you any arms or armor you might want. You won't find better anywhere in Defiance Bay, I can promise you that.
Now, time to see if that Valian was worth all that blood and copper.
He turns to his forge, hammer in hand. He takes a polished breastplate and goes to work.
I'll be damned. To be honest, even I wasn't expecting it to work this well. Back to it. Cleaver will want me to finish the rest of them. And it sounded like he has a job for you, too.
Show me what you have for sale. The White Spire. I don't want that. I want to look at it. The White Spire was found among the possession of a member of the Order of Bleakwalkers. Who the hell are they? Though it seems to have predated her. The spiraling engravings upon the blade are flanked by small, finely etched symbols of binding and enchantment, which might be credited with the permanent chill of the metal and the thin dusting of frost upon the Estoc's hilt. It's an Estoc. Unfortunately, it's a slow weapon. I hate slow weapons. Inflicts minus 5 all defenses for 5 seconds on hit. Grants blizzard. Ooh. Well, and we've got fine stuff here. Heldrick's coat. Heavy armor. Unique. Freeze proofed. Plus 3 damage reduction to freeze. Plus 4 damage reduction. Plus 30 defense against prone attacks. Plus 15 attacks, defense against push attacks. Speed minus 50%. An anomaly among Red Sarens. Heldrick was a renowned explorer. If there was a stretch of land that could be trod upon, he endeavored to reach it. He became enamored with the harsh beauty of the white that wins after an early expedition, and resolved to travel there as often as he was able. Accustomed to more temperate climes, he pooled the coin he gathered selling exotic artifacts to commission armor which might protect him against the bitter cold of the southern reaches. We've got exceptional and fine stuff. Forge master's gloves. Grant's firebrand. These gloves are made of a thick flame-retardant leather that can protect the wearer's hands from the heat of the forge. They are warm to the touch. These once belonged to a weaponsmith of the Deadfire Archipelago. His skill brought many customers to his shop, but as a large percentage of them were pirates and criminals, he frequently found himself robbed of his fine stock. He had his forge gloves enchanted with spells that would ensure that he was never caught defenseless by thieves. Shod in faith. Consecrated ground. Grants consecrated ground. The priestess who first wore these boots was a devotee of Barath, and so steadfast in her faith, then she eschewed the use of healing spells and potions in battle. She believed that Barath would preserve her until the end of her appointed cycle, at which point the god of life and death would take her soul's due. Even others in the priesthood scoffed at her recklessness, and yet she was never felled in battle. The most furious onslaughts of her enemies only seemed to revitalize her, and she was a very old woman when she finally passed in her sleep. Now, consecrated ground is a priest spell. Hmm? So it regenerates ally endurance and our own, or just the one who's wearing it?
Yes?
Okay, give it to our wizard. He turns from the forge, setting his hammer on the work table. Eh? You need anything? Dunstan yells, as if deafened by repeated hammer blows. Probably is almost deafened.
I'm a forge master.
Oh. I know that. Anything else we have? Besides this? Oh, that's expensive. What do we have to sell? Let's see what we have to sell. What was that? Hold up. Aru Brecker? Unique heavy armor. That must have been who that named NPC who was holding... What's her name? Anna? Vianna? She must have been wearing that. Aru Brecker. This robust brigandine has been repeatedly reinforced by the Adirian adventurer who once owned it. Thickly padded, the armor was dubbed Arrowbreaker. It served the adventurer well until her fame and fortune made her grow complacent, and she allowed an opponent to get too close. While Arrowbreaker protected her from projectiles, it didn't provide the same protection against a mace to the side of her head. I guess not. Well, we don't need that. We're not wearing heavy stuff like that, right? Alright. Okay, so maybe now we can get these boots. Well, we could get them anyway, but we have more money now. They're expensive. We got them. I think our wizard could use all he can get. Cool. Boots of stealth he already has.
All right. Of course.
Yeah.
Well, we're supposed to go talk to what's his name also? Clyver. There's no other way out of this room. Run as if your lives depended on it. No one has anything to say about what's his name being dead. Or missing, or whatever. How may I be of assistance? Was there more you needed me to do, actually? How may I be of assistance?
Dunstan will complete the first squad of Forge Knights in no time. Now the High Justice will want to have his Forge Masters at Fleetbreaker Castle create more. I've made a copy of Vianna's research, and the High Justice has sent a courier to Anslog's Compass to retrieve it. The dozens have gotten too active for the courier to come to Defiance Bay. And after Vianna's kidnapping, we've got to assume they know about our plans. That's why I'm sending you to deliver the research. You shouldn't be recognizable to the dozens. Yet.
wish I probably would have really helped them out. Sagani says, "Hi, Justice. This sounds big. But after this, I expect they'll learn of your association with us, and they won't be too happy about it. Neither will the Dominels." He snorts. "They're trying to expand the family business, and they resent us for standing in the way." Sure, consider it done. Why not?
Anslug's compass is a small lagoon just north of Defiance Bay. Your contact will be a commander named Arinrode. She'll meet you by the docks. Return to me when you've finished. The High Justice has made the expansion of the Forge Knights his top priority, which means it's mine as well.
Alright. Well, we'll do that at some point. I don't plan on leaving the city anytime soon. Gonna wrap up any quests we can while we're here, and I still have to explore all of Heritage Hill and finish exploring Andra's Gift. So with that, we'll be on our way.
Hi.
Now, is this a power that he has with these boots, or it's just no?
I shall.
Is it finally daylight in this place? Brackenbury, Andra's Gift. Alright. Let's go to this abandoned house. We're at full strength now. Messengers from Gilded Vale bring shocking news. Lord Radric the Seventh, local Thane of the Deerwood, has been slain. He is succeeded by Kulsk, last surviving relative of the Radric line. True. Stalwart sent the plans for assistance. They've been attacked by ogres and fear they could be sacked any day. Stalwart a place, I guess?
Nice and quiet.
I don't trust these abandoned houses. There's baddies in them. Addicts in here. What are you doing in here? This is our place. I could really use a pinch. I'd pinch you on your butt, but you're sitting on it. The man wears a worried expression, trembling from head to toe, continually licking his gums. What's in here? A dozen tiny somethings squirm within the pot of rice. Ugh. Svef. Oh, I don't want that crap. Alright, done here. Now, right next to this is someone else's house, which is not abandoned. Colfeg's house. We've heard of him. We need a glossary for all these NPCs. We'll get a refresher course once we talk to him. So no one needs to level up. No one wants to talk to us. Okay. The knob on the underside suggests that the table was fashioned from a derelict door. The slightest pressure causes it to wobble atop the barrels.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea. What?
I shall be as quiet as a calm sea. What? That was funny. Thank you very much. Oh, you can keep the oil. A youngish elven man squints at you in surprise. can't just barge into someone's home like this. Who do you think you are? Who are you? The elf who lives here. Now get out. What now? He looks at you nervously. Leave? Oh, that was awkward.
This elder of yours, he may have returned a drunk or an invalid.
Maybe, but the search for Persok is just as important as what I find.
Is that right? And what if you return empty-handed, eh?
I never return empty-handed.
Heritage Hill claims another curious soul. And a curious soul was he. We remind all visitors to Defiance Bay that this hill is sealed for your protection, and furthermore that the trade of Ingwithin artifacts is strictly forbidden. Yeah. Shove it up your fine elven arse. Let's check out this place here. Commoners. Well, here's these thugs. Well, now that they're out here, we can harass them back. I guess we were supposed to catch them in the act. What have we here? Another tourist and the gift. He nods to his shifty-eyed companions. Let's give her a proper welcome. Well, they're harassing me. Let's talk this through. He draws a sharpened blade and smiles. I'm afraid you're missing the point, friend. All right, friend. We've got harassing thug, harassing thug, harassing thug, harassing thug, and harassing thug. So where's that named one? All right. Have at thee, harassing thugs. I'll go for that one. And, Aloth's just gonna wait a sec. Amplified thrust off of Eater again. We'll do that. We're not in combat yet. Now we're in combat. Holy Radiance.
Hey.
Okay. Now, unfortunately, we've surrounded them all, so I can't use a fireball. I love this theme. It's awesome. I like how they just change the themes. Soul Shock off of Eater. And then Theodos will join the fray after that. Necrotic Lance on this one. Pillar of Faith also. About this one, he'll get his two friends while he's at it. Tana's already got injured a little bit, so these guys are gonna be pretty tough.
Lava will be on seat.
Did we get him? We didn't hit him that hard. 41. Oh. 41 corrode damage. Well, he's pretty tough. Again. Which one is Eater on? Not like I could tell what the hell's going on here. Sagani, Peter. That guy fall? I can't even tell. Looks like, yeah, it looks like he fell. He's getting up. Alright. Nice. Alright. Finish off this guy, Theodos. Nice. One hit. That was all it took. You're making her look good. She is good. Knocked down again. You are not allowed to get up, sir. Let's throw a minor heal into the mix. I can't cast that because... minor missile. Again. One left? Iron on him. And just like that, it ended. What? You know, they should make special items stand out, like a glow or something. Because, you know, what if this one's wearing a special named armor, and that one's just plain leather armor? That's how I missed that one. I almost missed it. Rusty bronze key! For what? I guess we'll find out, because our quest was updated.
What?
One of the thugs dropped a key that looks like it belongs to a house and Andre's gift. Was there a house we weren't able to get into? I don't recall. I do not recall. Could be Otto's house? I don't know.
Hi.
Alright. So stay tuned for next episode when we enter Otto's house and Otto's house. See if that has anything to do with this quest. If not, we'll look around anyway. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. Enduring, grow strong.